Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be explaining quarks in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you wouldn't mind, please like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. All right, everybody, let's talk about quarks. Now, this is a parameter that will pack all arguments into a dictionary. It's useful so that a function can accept a varying amount of keyword arguments. It's identical to args, except with args, args will accept a varying amount of positional arguments and pack them into a tuple. With quarks, this will accept a varying amount of keyword arguments and pack them into a dictionary. So here's an example of why this would be useful. Let's say we have a function called hello that accepts two keyword arguments, a first name and a last name. All this will do is output hello, your first name and last name. But what if somebody has more than two names? Let's say somebody has a middle name. And for this example, I'll just say my middle name is dude. So if I were to run this, well, this hello function is no longer going to work. As you can see in the console window, we have a type error. The hello function got an unexpected keyword argument middle. One way in which we can solve this, we can use this quarks parameter so we can accept a varying amount of keyword arguments. So what we'll do is replace our parameters with two asterisks, then quarks. Now, if I would like the same output as I had before, I'm going to need to change a few things around. In order to access a value within a dictionary, you type the name of the dictionary, square brackets, and then within quotes, list your key. So I would like to access the value at this key of first. And let's repeat the process for last name. So the key is going to be last. We'll access this value at this key. And this should work the same as it did before. Now let's take this a step further. Let's say we would like to display somebody's full name based on the amount of keyword arguments that they pass into this function. Well, there's a few different ways in which we could do this. One easy way is that we could write our program like this. Let's print the word hello, and we will need to iterate once through each key value pair within this dictionary, and we can use a for loop to do that. So to iterate once through each key value pair in your dictionary, we'll type for key value in the name of our dictionary, quarks in this case, dot items, and then we will print each value. So there's one more thing that we need to do. This kind of works as intended, but it's going to print each value, including our word hello, on a new line. So with a standard print statement, this will print a new line character after each print statement as if we're hitting enter. We can actually change that. So after your string, add end equals, and we can replace that new line character with something else, maybe a space. And let's do the same thing for our for loop. So value, comma, end, and then just add a space. Now this will print all of your names all in the same line. Hello, bro, dude, code. And now we can pass in a varying amount of keyword arguments based on how long our name is. Perhaps we have like a title. Title equals Mr. And we can print that as well. Hello, Mr. Bro, dude, code. Here's a fun fact of the day. You don't necessarily need to name this parameter as quarks. The important thing is to have these double asterisks that precede it. Quarks is just a common naming convention. It's short for keyword arguments. You could name this as something else, perhaps something more descriptive like names, since we're passing in a bunch of names. So the name of our dictionary is now names, and this would work the same as it did before. The important thing is to have these double asterisks that precede the name of your dictionary. But quarks is the common naming convention. Well, everybody, that's all about quarks. It's a parameter that will pack a varying amount of keyword arguments into a dictionary. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post this in the comments section down below. But yeah, that is how quarks works in Python. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.